Let's get an update on the three restive volcanoes in the country. We have on the line Mariton Bornas. She's the chief of the Volcano Monitoring and Prediction Division at FEVOLCS. Good afternoon, Mariton, again. Thanks for talking to us despite it's a busy day.
Good afternoon, Stanley.
Okay, let's talk about Mayon first. Is an eruption imminent based on the signs that you're seeing there?
Okay, technically Mayon volcano is already erupting, but the heat is quite slow.
Okay, already so erupting, is that what you're saying? Is it already erupting?
Yes, it is already erupting when we raise the alert level to C. But okay. The rate of the extrusion of lava is very low. Okay. That's why we have been seeing incandescent rockfall, that is new lava already being spewed out by the volcano, but also we are also seeing pyroclastic density currents. These are turbulent masses of volcanic gas, ash, and fragmented rock material, mm-hmm. which are the primary volcanic hazards of Mayon, that are already rushing down the slopes, on the southern slopes, and parts of the eastern slopes, up to 2 kilometers since June 8. So that's why we already raised the alert level. The only difference now is we are not seeing explosive activity, and we are not seeing any acceleration yet of the extrusion or the eruption rate. It's still quite very slow.
Okay, so officially, what level are we now for Mayon?
We are still at alert level 3 since June 8th. This means that there is an increased tendency towards hazardous eruption. And we are monitoring all other parameters because this activity, unrest at Mayon, is now occurring at given the background or the low-level parameters. No, we do not see any increases in sulfur dioxide beyond baseline levels. There has been practically no volcanic earthquake activity, only one or two in a few days. So this is very atypical behavior. We only have minimal swelling of the edifices. So all of this activity is occurring under really low levels of unrest, but it's already erupting.
Okay, already erupting, low level of unrest. What are the chances that you are going to up alert levels to 4 anytime soon, and what signs perhaps are you looking for to do that?
Okay, we need to look at the day-to-day, hour-to-hour changes in the monitoring parameters. So we need to watch very closely the sulfur dioxide emission of the volcano. If there is any new state of volcanic seismicity, and also if there is renewed swelling of the edifices, especially the lower slopes, which will signal the intrusion of deep-seated magma into the edifices of the volcano. So we have to look at this day to day and assess the outlook for the volcano. So far, if this kind of unrest or this kind of extrusion rate, or the rate of outpouring of lava persists, then we may see only a very short period of eruption. So similar to the 2014, in which the Mayon spewed out a very short lava flow from the summit crater, and formed a new dome, then the activity ceased. So right now, if this if the current state of parameters persists, this is what we will be looking at. But again, Mayon is an open vent volcano. Any of these signs can change in a given day. Okay. That is why you have to monitor and assess this day to day, even hour to hour sometimes.
Okay, that's it for Mayon volcano. We do hope for the best case scenario there. Let's go to Taal now. They are saying activity has been easing. Is that an indication that we are out of the woods as far as Taal is concerned?
Well, we are not looking at any increased potential for eruption. We do, however, are still seeing a lot of degas activity from Taal volcano, just still from the magma that was in place beneath the volcano after the 2020 eruption. So today we have measured a total of 6,304 tons per day mm-hmm. of sulfur dioxide. Again, this is an increase from the previous measurements of barely 3,000 tons per day. And today we have recorded one low-frequency volcanic earthquake. This is activity. This is a volcanic earthquake associated with the with the movement of volcanic gas. But at least we have seen the low-level tremor, mm-hmm. which is vibration caused by passage of volcanic fluid. That began in June 2 and yesterday. So okay. The volcanic tremor already ended yesterday.
Okay, finally, let's talk about Mount Canlaonaw in Negros Occidental. Now, it's been a while since its last major eruption. What is the status at Mount Canlaon?
So for today, Canlaon has seemed to quiet down. So we have not recorded any volcanic earthquakes today.
Okay. Okay, on that note, we won't hold you any further. Thanks a lot for your time, Mariton Bornas of the Volcano Monitoring and Prediction Division of EVOX. Thank you so much for your time. Hope to hear again from you soon.
Okay, thank you po. Ingat po tayo.
Stay safe.